One good thing about music is when it hits you, you feel no pain, unless your eardrums and lungs explode. Hello everyone, Julian here for D News. At worst, loud noises are an annoyance. Your neighbor's got the stereo cranked out, a baby in a movie theater won't stop crying, you live near a police siren testing facility, whatever. Sure, you'll be irritated, but you'll live. Or will you?
Bum bum bum!
Is it possible for a sound to be so loud it makes you dead? The European Space Agency seems to think so. The ESA actually has an array of four gigantic horns at the large European acoustic facility in Noordwijk, the Netherlands. And if they crank it up to 11, the horns can produce sound as loud as 154 decibels, which they reckon could definitely burst your eardrums right away and maybe cause serious damage from long-term exposure. But those freaky-deaky Dutch aren't using their horn section of doom as a weapon. They're using it to see if satellites can withstand the sound of a rocket launch. See, sound is a mechanical wave caused by oscillations in air pressure. The greater the change in air pressure, the higher the amplitude, the more energy it carries, and the louder we interpret that sound to be. If a sound is loud enough, or at the right frequency, it can shake something to pieces. This is why the Space Shuttle's launch platform would dump 350,000 gallons of water onto itself during launch to dampen the sound and keep it from damaging the shuttle. Otherwise, the 195 decibels the engines pumped out would put too much stress on the shuttle's wings. As it happens, it's speculated that 195 decibels is totally enough loudness to kill you dead. It's thought the threshold is anywhere from 185 to 200 decibels. Sound waves with that big of a pressure fluctuation might damage your lungs, either forcing an air bubble into your blood that would then cause cardiac arrest, or by making your lungs themselves pop. Not a lot of research on this has been done, though German researcher Jürgen Altman showed that a sound wave at 210 decibels caused lung damage. Research has been conducted on fish with and without air bladders to see if they were injured by the loud sounds caused by pile drivers. Those are the machines that pound bridge supports into the mud, not the wrestling move. And indeed, fish without air bladders showed no injuries, while the two species with air bladders were severely damaged by sound alone. So why doesn't some mad scientist just crank up those ESA horns and create a devastating sound gun? I mean, they're already 154 decibels, what's another 40? Well, it's not as easy as it sounds. Because the decibel scale is a bit misleading. People often quote that a conversation is around 60 decibels, a rock concert is 115 decibels, and so on. But what that explanation doesn't tell you is that the decibel scale is logarithmic. A sound at 90 decibels has 10 times the energy as a sound at 80 decibels. So, to get those monstrous European horns to lethal levels, the sound wave they generate would need to have 10,000 times more energy, and the change in air pressure they cause would be 100 times greater. If you'd want to make someone's head explode a la scanners, you'd probably have to have 100 times the amplitude again, going all the way up to 240 decibels. And keep in mind, you'd have to put the person's head right next to the sound source for that to happen, because sound dissipates. Now, I think it's safe to say that while sound can theoretically kill you, it's not going to happen. Just, you know, don't go wandering under any space shuttle rockets without hearing protection. Look, if you're one of those mad scientists who are looking to weaponize sound and use it for your own nefarious purposes, you should watch Trace's Ancient D News episode here.
The human ear can perceive these waves as long as their frequency is between 20 hertz and 20,000 hertz. Anything above or below that, we can't hear, but they're still there, because these waves contain energy. And with enough din, you can make these waves do some incredible things.
Are there any other things you think could be weirdly fatal that you want us to look into? Well, let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I will see you next time on D News.